for a job in the city, working for the man every night and day. Then I never lost a minute of speed, worrying about the way things might have been.
Big wheels keep on turning, proud Mary keep on burning.
Rolling,
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 rolling on the river. Seen a lot of places in Memphis,
a hot lot of places.
Kind of funny waving goodbye when really I want to be waving hello. Hello, Australia. Welcome to a very, very special Young Talent Time. Because during the course of the year in Young Talent Time, we hope to be saying hello to all of the wonderful capital cities of each state. And this week we start with the Garden State of Victoria. The Young Talent Team and yours truly will be travelling around looking at some of the wonderful sights in Victoria. So join us, won't you, as we pay a musical tribute to Melbourne on Young Talent Time. We'll be back to take you around in just a moment. When mums and dads bring their kids to Melbourne, one place that they never ever miss, or shouldn't miss anyway, is the Melbourne Zoo. It's been recently decorated and it's a really great place. A lot of Maxie's friends are there, right? They've got a special cage for you too, haven't they? Well, maybe you could visit Maxie down at the zoo too. I think he's only kidding. But one person that they've let out of the cage for this particular program, and I'm kidding there too, is Tiny Tina Arena. And she's got a really beautiful song down at the Melbourne Zoo. So here she comes.
Charming. We would fit. I could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting to a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting to a cheetah. What a neat achievement that would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. I'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. I would converse in polar bear and python, and I would curse in fluent kangaroo. If people ask me, can you speak rhinoceros? I'd say, of course yes. Can't you? If I conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of the amazing repartee. I could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to me. I consulted with quadrupeds, think what fun we'd have, asking over crocodiles for tea. Or maybe laughing two or three lines, walruses or sea lions. What a lovely place the world would be. If I spoke slang to the orangutans, the advantages any fool on earth can plainly see. Discussing Eastern art and dramas with intellectual llamas, that's a big step forward, you'll agree. I'd learn to speak in antelope and turtle. My Pekingese would be extremely good. If I were asked to sing in hippopotamus, I'd say why not? And would. If I could chat with a pelican, it's a fairy tale worthy of Hans Andersen or Grimm. Someone who walks with the animals, who talks with the animals.
Johnny Borrell's talking to the animals. And here's one animal that doesn't talk very much, is Maxie Mouse. An occasional little squeak we get out of you, don't we? Just a little teeny-weeny one. OK, our very special Young Talent Time look at Melbourne continues in just a moment. Gee, it's a beautiful day, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's the thing you like best, Bobby, about Melbourne?
The girls.
Oh, yeah, that'll kill you for saying that. No, not those kind of things, you know, about the things you can see. Well, I guess you can see girls.
The trams.
They're quite unique, aren't they? There's not many cities in the world, actually, that still use trams as a public form of transport.
No.
But also in Victoria, people are very, very proud of their railway systems.
Yeah.
And they're especially proud when a young lady like Nicole is standing on the station. I wonder why. She's pretty pretty too, isn't she?
Yeah.
Here's Nicole Cooper with the trains, everyone.
Come on, boy. Oh, come on, boy.
Beauty. You know, I used to work for the railways a long, long time ago, for the West Australian Railways. Maybe one day when we do a show in Western Australia, we could do a song there too. Hey, fellas, what do you reckon? Good idea. Hello to all my old mates down at the West Australian Railways packing department. That's where I used to work. Okay, down onto a serious note. Of course, we're in Melbourne taking a look at some of the sites, and some of the places in Melbourne are historically really quite serious and quite dramatic, like the old Melbourne Jail where Ned Kelly was hung. And some of them played a very significant part in Australians' history too, I have to tell you. Like Captain Cook's Cottage. That's, of course, Captain James Cook, who discovered the east coast of Australia. We're going to visit that right now. And a beautiful song from Bobby Dreeson. It's called There's a Place for Us Somewhere. Here's Bobby.
Somewhere a place for us.
nothing to recall. I've got my life to live, and I don't need you at all. Roller coaster ride we took is nearly at an end. I bought my ticket with my teeth. That's all I'm gonna spend, and I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball, and I think it's gonna be alright. Yeah, the worst is over now. The morning sun is shining like a red rubber ball.
Kids certainly seem to have a good time on the beach, don't they? Melbourne's beaches may not compare to some of the bigger beaches in the world like Hawaii, but, gee, they certainly have a good time. Thanks very much, Deb. A good song, too. And, of course, in Melbourne, like in most cities around Australia, there's always something to do for the kids. There's lots of parks with slides and swings, and, of course, the fairgrounds, too, and we're visiting one right now. So why don't you join me as we have a little look at the wonderful world of the young. Close your eyes, come with me, and we soon will be in the wonderful world of the young. Hearts remain 17, dreams are heart that I give, and will always live in the wonderful world of the young. In the wonderful world of the young. Some fools, they may deny it, but wise men know the truth. They have discovered that love is youth. Take this heart that I give, and we'll all. We're having a typical Melbourne barbecue here. Lots of sunshine, a couple of flies, and a few nut sundaes hanging around the place. They're a happy lot, aren't they? Now, of course, there's lots of snags and there's lots of chops and stuff like that. And being a vegetarian, I've got a French dish here called a tomato sandwich, which has been mutilated by the young talent team. We thought we'd take this opportunity to sing a special song for all those people right around Melbourne who've made us so welcome in the filming of this particular special program. So thanks to all of you, and especially to the people from the Parks and Gardens Boards who were so helpful in allowing us to park places where maybe we shouldn't have. Thank you very much. Here's a song just for you. Well, this, oh, that's a beautiful song, isn't it? No, don't look at the tomato when I say a beautiful song. I'll have to rename this tomato dish here. We'll have to call it tomatoes a la squash. Yeah, tomatoes a la slop, I was going to say. It's pretty close to it. Okay, seriously now, kids, because while we're having our little snack here, it's time to introduce our very special guest from our Young Talentine family. And I'm talking, of course, about Robert McCullough, who's got a beautiful song made popular by Billy Joel, right? And it's called My Life. So here's Robert and a song about his life. Welcome back to our very special Young Talent Time look at the Garden City of Melbourne. When we were planning the program and having a look at around at all the beautiful places in Melbourne, we discovered that there were a lot more than we could possibly fit in one program. So right now, we'd like to take you on a little journey through Melbourne and a beautiful song from one of our Young Talent Team members, Karen Knowles, and People Who Need People in Melbourne.
special people. Says you are half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst, but first be a person who needs me.
Song, isn't it? People who need people. Speaking of people, this people here happens to be a Melbourne people, right?
This is right.
Melbourne born and raised, our Robert. Tell me, honestly, Robert, what is the thing you like best about Melbourne?
I'd say everything.
Everything? they're very biased, these Melbourne people, folks. I tell you. No, quite seriously, Robert, what do you think is the most obvious beautiful thing about Melbourne?
I think the gardens are tremendous. Yeah. Always kept them. Condition.
I guess the powers to be naming Victoria the Garden State were pretty spot on, weren't they?
That's right.
Well, let's join the young talent team right now as they take another little trip to one of Melbourne's most beautiful gardens. And what an appropriate song. Everything is beautiful. The young talent team.
Giving everything a reason.
Well, it's nearly time for us to say goodbye from this very special Young Talent Time on Tour program from beautiful Garden State of Victoria and here in Melbourne. Before we go, of course, we'd like to thank everyone right around Melbourne for making us so welcome in the different locations and for really giving us such a good time. And maybe next time, anywhere, wherever you are in Australia, we may be calling on you and doing a very special show from you. Hey, where would you like to go, Nick?
Surf's Paradise.
Oh, of course, Surf's Paradise. Get a suntan. Where would you like to go, Tina?
Sydney.
Sydney's a good place. Channel 10 up there in Sydney. We might be doing a program up there. That'd be nice. Where would you like to go, Johnny Bowles?
Nanagoon.
Nanagoon. What a Nanagoon. Where's Nanagoon?
I'm not sure.
I wish I had. What about you, Stephen?
Adelaide.
Adelaide. I've got an auntie called Adelaide. That's in South Australia. Nice churches there, yes. Channel 10 in Adelaide shows Young Talent Time. Hello to our Adelaide friends. What about you, Debbie?
Madjeri Bar.
Okay, where's Madjeri Bar?
It's right near surface.
Right near surface, right.
It's a bit inland. It's
well, really maybe nice. We could do a combined Madjeri Bar, Surface Paradise, Coolangatta, Tweed Heads, Burnley Heads show.
Well, this would be good.
Anyway, it'd be nice to get a suntan, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Lovely.
Good idea. And what about you, Karen?
Hobart's,
oh, beautiful, a nice and historical Port Arthur and all those places. That'd be a good one, yes. And you, Robert?
Coo-wee-wup.
Where's Coo-wee-wup?
I think it's at the Dandenong somewhere.
Oh, that's... And thanks for being on the show too, Bob. And of course, our animals here would like to go to the zoo and do a program. We might do that too, Young Talent Time. But of course, it's time for us to say goodbye now. So we hope you've enjoyed our show. We'll see you all next week for another fun Young Talent Time and lots of very special songs for you. So see you then, everybody. Goodbye.
Close your eyes and I'll kiss you. Tomorrow I'll miss you. Remember, I'll always be true. And then while I'm away, I'll write home every day, and I'll send all my those lips I am missing, and hope that your dreams all come true. And then while I'm away, I'll write home every day, and I'll say true.
Young Talent Time is a Television House production, produced at the studios of Channel O Melbourne for the O10 Network.